since the beginning of advertising formed or started, this is how it worked, right? It's a one-way street. Information flows in a singular direction. Not much is coming back this way, right? Maybe occasionally there's some dollars trickling this way for a subscription, or most of the media is free though in this scale. One direction, right? This is how it's been since the beginning of media until very recently with the advent of social, right? And social kept most of the flow of money the same. It didn't affect anything here, right? The business is mostly paying for the content for distribution, but now what we have is a reciprocal engine, the social layer, if you will, that allows everyone to kind of start building their voice and sharing feedback in a loop, right? But the advertising dollars haven't changed here. Since the beginning of advertising, it's been about build the biggest audience and then rent that audience to others for a fee, right? But if we consider how we move forward, how important it is as a business or as a brand to own your audience, as opposed to renting it or being beholden to somebody else to reach it, you start to see where it becomes imperative to have or manage that relationship. You rent depreciating assets, you invest in appreciating assets. An audience should be an appreciating asset. You should want to own that, right? You don't want to rent your audience, right? And so what we're seeing as this evolves, as people start to worry about privacy and security and how does this work, we start to see a new layer being built in between.
If there's nothing but a bunch of individuals in one giant tech platform like a Facebook or a Google, there's this bizarre situation where we're petitioning the central authority that we have no other power over, that we didn't vote for, to police our own speech and to police our own behavior. And it's just not tenable. We're demanding authoritarianism. And the way around that is to create middle-sized organizations that are analogous to things like scientific journals or universities or trade unions or many other examples. You can voluntarily join these things and they can become brands in themselves that enforce quality, and become trustworthy.
So as I was preparing this, I'm thinking like he literally is describing this layer here that nobody knows exists yet or that nobody knows is being built, but that is being built by the people who care because they see the behaviors, the market is adapting to solve some of these problems by itself.